Is that when you started Empire Films then?
No, I started that a little later. But I immediately then went into production. I found this incredible story in Italy, which was House of Flesh Mannequins, directed and written by this Italian director who had the same name as me. And I never met anyone with the same name, Domiziano. In fact, you can call me Domi if you want, because it's so long. But
I like Domiziano.
Thank you. You actually say it perfectly. So
okay, thank you.
Thank you. So he wrote this great story, and his producer was really funny enough, because he is the son of Joe D'Amato, which was this huge genre producer and director of films, and I had worked with his father back in the early 80s in 3 films. So they knew me, and they wanted me, they said, Domi would be great for this part. And when I called them up and I say I want to produce this, they said, oh, that's great, because we actually wanted to offer you the part. So it's great that you really want to produce it too. And so, you know, that was the main first real film that I produced. And after that, it was one after the other.
Okay,
I mean, so 6 so far.
Okay, so you have House of Flesh Mannequins, and then what did you do from there?
House of Flesh Mannequins, and let's see in the order, Orgy of Blood, also with Creep Creepers in, which is now, you know, being sold all over the world by Shoreline Entertainment, which is big. And then Box of Shadows, which turned out incredibly well, and also we have huge expectations as distribution. So they're all independent films. Then I did, of course, H1N1, Virus X, which is another outstanding film. Lionsgate really wants it. We'll see. I hope we can, you know, go through with the deal and sell it, because it would be a great distribution for it. And I'm co-starring with another idol of mine, and also another 70s, 80s genre star, Sybil Danning.
Oh, so, she's beautiful. Oh, that's great.
Yeah, she's fantastic still. So it was great. And after that, Lizzie, which is, period horror / Western, and now The Brides of Sodom. Mm-hmm. And right after, I'm working already on Doctor Sleep, another film.
Okay, and are you going to be starring in that one too?
Yes. Yeah, they are actually writing the story for me. I hope I deserve it.
You do after everything you've done.
It's a tough business. I've been around enough to know that sometimes you have to be very humble. I was fortunate to meet, you know, Mickey Rourke, Sean Connery, when I was younger, younger and just a nobody. And, you know, and I learned so much. It's a lesson of humility and, you know, you try to do the best you can and you give a lot. To the camera, you give a lot to your directors, to your producers, and you love. I mean, you love. It's a huge commitment, and it's a huge sort of like devoted attitude that you gotta have if you wanna make it through this business, because it's so many ups and downs, and you know, as you know probably, and. It's tough, but then it's beautiful. It's rewarding because we're able to do what we love.
And you have done so many things and you've been successful at them. What do you love the most?
That's a tough one because I loved many films. I hate a few. But
that you didn't have control over then.
No,
right?
I was just, you know, acting and, you know, keep keep, you know, ticketing, you know, that way. And that's part of being a professional too, I believe. But I love a movie that I did. That was really my first breakthrough as a lead actor. I was only, want to tell you, 16. And I was cast in this movie, which was called The Boy from Ebalus. It was a very tragic story of a very young boy who gets, you know, involved in the underworld of drugs and being used as a sex slave to pay his bills, increasing bills of heroin addiction. Yeah. And it was a beautiful story which was presented at the Venice Film Festival in 1984. And I was cast opposite another cult actress, which became a, you know, very close personal friend. And her name is Therese Ansavoy, Teresa, as we say in Europe, mm-hmm. Ansavoy. And she was huge at the time because she was the lead and the protagonist of the Tinto Brass Caligula with Peter O'Toole and Malcolm McDowell and John Gielgud. And she had done also Salon Kitty, another very controversial movie that was, you know, huge back in the early 80s. So she was an international star, older than me, and I was, you know, a young boy, but we made friends, and, you know, and I love that movie.
We'll have to look it up then. What was the name of it again?
The Boy from Ebalus.
And where can we find it?
You know, I don't think, unfortunately, it's not distributed here in the United States. Oh. You can find it in DVD in Europe, everywhere, but not here, unfortunately.
You should get a copy and distribute it yourself then.
You know, maybe I will. If, you know, if there are the right chances, I mean, if there is the right moment to do it, I'll do it because I'm really, I don't know, I haven't seen it in a while, but that was my favorite movie.
It sounds like a great film.
And of course, always the same. Now I love The Brides of Sodom. It's always about looking forward and it's about the next project. So now it's all about The Brides of Sodom. So I'm really, really happy with this.
And where will we be able to see Brides of Sodom?
Brides of Sodom is already confirmed in the official competition of the International Film Festival of Erotica Film in Paris.
When is that?
At the end of July, mm-hmm. 2009. And we have a bigger festival here in the US. I mean, I can't say the name because we're not 100% confirmed, but they are very interested. So chances are we may actually show the movie even before that. That will be an international premiere. And if we go to this festival, that will be the official US festival.
Okay, premiere. Will it be local so we can see it?
Local, Los Angeles, yeah.
Okay, that's great. Well, I'm looking forward to seeing it because it looks like a great movie. Such an interesting set and great cast and great executive producer and director. Okay, well, thank you very much for inviting us to your
absolutely.
Set.
Absolutely, and thank you for watching. And I mean, beautiful host. So
thank you.
I'm sure you guys are happy to see this.